The surface integral of a vector field is sometimes called a flux integral. And the flux integral usually has some physical meaning. I think originally it came from fluid mechanics, so let me discuss it first in that context. That's called the mass flux. And that has the formula that the integral over the surface of the density of the fluid times the velocity of the fluid dotted into ds, okay? So let's try and break down what exactly is the meaning of mass flux. So rho is the density. So let me use this bracket to denote the units of rho. So a density has units of mass per unit volume, or here length cubed. That's the density of the fluid, right? The velocity of the fluid has units of length per unit time, so length over time. That's the velocity. And then we're integrating over the surface. So the units of our surface is going to be length squared, right? So an area has units of length squared. So putting it together, the units of our mass flux, the units of this integral, rho u dot ds, then, multiplying these three together, the length cubed cancels the length cubed, and we end up with units of mass per unit time. Okay? So the mass flux then is the, as the fluid flows through this surface, right? It has to, you're dotting with the normal vector to the surface because the fluid is flowing through the surface. The mass flux then is the mass per unit time of the fluid that flows through this surface S, okay? That's in the context of fluid mechanics. We also have, in the context of electricity and magnetism, we have both the electric flux and we also have the magnetic flux. These flux integrals will be the integral over the surface of the electric field dot ds, and the magnetic flux will be the integral over the surface of the magnetic field dot ds. So these quantities show up in the integral form of Maxwell's equations. So let me give a simple example here. If we have a charge, basically fixed at the origin, so a charge Q at the origin, the electric field of that charge is given by the charge Q over 4 pi epsilon naught times R squared, epsilon naught is a constant, in the direction of the radial vector from the origin. Okay, so it's spherically symmetrical electric field. So let's say that we want to compute the electric flux then through a sphere. So we can draw our sphere here, and we have our charge Q then in the center of the sphere, right? So we want to compute then the electric flux around the sphere, closed surface, of E dot ds, what would we get? So now the electric field on the surface has some radius, so I'm going to call that capital R. So the electric field on the surface then is going to be Q over 4 pi epsilon naught R squared, and then the normal vector is R hat here. So the normal vector to the surface is r hat. So we have E dot ds will be r hat ds. So r hat is 1. So this will be the integral over the surface ds. So let me put an s here to denote that we're integrating over the surface of the sphere. So this is just a constant. So this is q over 4 pi epsilon naught capital R squared times the surface area of a sphere, which is 4 pi R squared. So it's q over 4 pi epsilon naught R squared times 4 pi R squared. And then we get just q over epsilon naught. Okay? So the electric flux due to a point charge q at the origin across a sphere of radius r is actually independent of the radius of the sphere and is given by the electric charge over this permittivity constant epsilon naught. Okay? That's actually one of Maxwell's equations. Okay, so let me summarize. In this video, I wanted to introduce the physical the physical meaning of a flux integral. This is the surface integral of a vector field. For a mass flux, it's the mass per unit time that passes through the surface. Is given by the integral of rho u dot ds. For the electric flux and the magnetic flux, it's the integral of E dot ds through the surface for electric fields, electric flux, and B dot ds for magnetic flux. Then I worked the simple example of a charge q at the origin. What is the electric flux through a sphere centered at the origin? It's equal to the charge q divided by epsilon naught. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.